Is there a dinosaur living in a Scottish lake? 565 AD, the River Ness, Scotland. St. Columba forbids a fearsome creature from attacking one of his followers. A legend begins. 1933, Loch Ness. A new road is built alongside the once isolated loch. Soon afterwards, there is a media frenzy when Mr. and Mrs. George Spicer see a most extraordinary form of animal step in front of their car. There's a monster on the loose, and evidence is needed, and it's quickly forthcoming. The first photographs of the monster were taken that same year. Then, the most famous image of the creature is taken in 1934 by Dr. Robert Kenneth Wilson, the surgeon's photograph. That same year, monster footprints are found by the big game hunter Marmaduke Wetherell. More sightings and photographs follow through to the present day, including underwater images of the creature's gargoyle-like head. Somehow a prehistoric creature, possibly a plesiosaur, has survived to the present day. Or has it? Marmaduke Wetherell, the game hunter, was sponsored by the Daily Mail newspaper to track the monster. They soon lost interest after he was duped by a local using a hippopotamus's foot umbrella stand to fake monster footprints. Humiliated, Wetherell decides to give the Mail what they want, photographs of the monster. Wetherell adapts a toy submarine to stand in for the monster and casts it off across the loch. He slips the subsequent film and photographs to a fellow conspirator, Wilson the surgeon, who sells them on to the Daily Mail. For a creature to survive so long, it would need to be part of a breeding herd, so why isn't the loch full of monsters? As for the 1970s underwater image of the monster's head, it was found to be a decaying tree stump. Have you seen Nessie? Why, in this era of digital cameras and smartphone saturation, has the number of monster photographs not shot through the roof? Discuss in the comments below, and adios, monster hunters.